David Einhorn says that we are in an enormous bubble. And let me just qualify that for you, because it's quite a statement. He says what matters in a bubble is market psychology, not valuation. But he does, I've got to say, he does go on to talk about this lunacy, this mania that we have in IPOs, extraordinary valuations, and he has a bubble basket. Does it feel like a bubble, look like a bubble, remind you of a bubble? Are we in a bubble?
No. If you put a gun to my head, I would still say no. We are moving towards a bubble, perhaps, in certain segments of the market. But I would disagree with the overall condition, even though there are many elements. I mean, he's not wrong on these elements that typically constitute a bubble. But just to give you an example, you know, you can sort of wonder about the strength of the tech stocks. But, you know, they do make 20-25% of the earnings that are out there. So, you know, the market is not extremely far away by giving them that much of a weight in the indices. Their earnings are up year over year. You know, they're up 10 to 20%, depending on which subsector or which title you look at, whereas the overall market's earnings are down. So the market is actually quite rationally. It is rewarding companies that have business models that are, you know, ready and good for the new age and are leaving the rest behind. So I think that's a pretty rational behavior. Now, in individual stocks, let's not mention names that start with a T, but you might see increased elements of you know, what you would call exuberance, but I don't think it's the case in general. And even those names that have perhaps a bit of exaggerated exuberance in there, maybe they will be proven right in the long term. The case is out there for them. But in general, I don't think we're yet in a bubble.